Hi everyone, Leo here. So welcome back to our App Inventor tutorials. This is lesson 3. Before our lesson start, I just want to say something about our emulator. So remember last week we tried our emulator. And one thing about the emulator is that it's convenient once you load it. So I'm going to show you guys why. So here in our App Inventor webpage, when we put some buttons in it, so our emulator just load it directly. If we delete it, it just disappears. So it's kind of dynamic and you don't need to reload everything. So when I design my apps using App Inventor, I usually have this kind of layout. The web page is in the middle and I put my emulator on the side so I can see both sides. So what we are going to do today is we are going to make a little apps where we have buttons and image, and if we hit a button, it's kind of do something to the image, so like maybe showing the image and hiding the image. So let's start by creating a new project called lesson 3. And here's our empty screen one. The first thing we're going to do is we put buttons there, one for showing the picture, one for hiding picture. The layout thing, I'm going to introduce it in next lesson, so just keep it in this way first. Also an image. Remember how we upload image is using the media here. We upload a file, so just choose an image you like and go to image tab and select our picture. Adjust the height and the width. Okay, I'm good. So we need to rename our buttons, because if we are doing good coding part, we go to blocks here, you can see button 1 and button 2. We do not know which button is going to work for what function, so remember to use proper names for your components. Since we only have an image, so I'm just going to keep the name of image 1 here, but for button 1 and button 2, we have to rename it. So one's for show image, one is for hide image. Okay, so we have to change our test too. Here, just name it short show and hide. Oh, sorry, typo. Okay. Here's our two buttons and the image. Now we are moving to the blocks view. Here first we're gonna do this. We go to show image, and what we want the program to do is if we hit the show button, the image shows up, and if we hit the hide button, the image is being invisible. If we press the show button again, it pops up. So the show image dot click is referring to, you can see App Inventor, it tells you what this function is doing. So this is what I want, so I drag it out, and I also want to drag hide image button dot click. So we have two components here, two blocks. One is for the show image button and one is for the hide image button. So now we're moving the image. Here's a lot of controls to our image. We want to set our image to be invisible. So here we can see set image 1.visible. So this function blocks is going to make our image visible or invisible. So we drag one out and we copy one. So copy and paste using Ctrl Z and Ctrl V. So we put it under here, it's like a puzzle. So it's not complete yet, so here a warning button, a warning, because you can see the puzzle is not complete. So what we want to do is show image. We want to show our image, so the visibility of image 1 should be true, so it means it is visible. We go to logic and we find it true, just similar to show image button. We are going to drag a false to hide image button. So here you go, when we click the show image button, our image 1 is going to be visible. When we hit the hide button, our image 1 is going to be not visible, so invisible. Here, our emulator, we kind of try things out. So the image here, I hit hide, it disappeared. I hit show, it appeared again. So it's a little function of hiding your picture and showing your picture. We go back to designer. So this is what I'm going to discuss in the next lesson, about the alignment of the components. So this is our lesson 3, little apps. See you guys next week. Goodbye.